Sorry, you're gonna cause a domain. The radiation.
It's gonna bring you down by your own finger, by your own nuclear power. It's gonna bring you down.
Look at this picture right here, my people. This is the before picture. Look at this picture right here. Look how this is where they grow their crops. This is where they grow their crops. Look at how far they stretch back. This is the before picture. Now watch the after. Watch the after. Watch the after. Oh. Watch the after. And it's still raining over there. It's still raining. Huh? Come on. Too motherfucking late. It's too late. Hold on, my people. Hold on.
No apologies.
No apologies, man.
IBA. That's the boy name.
Data. Listen, my people. Oh, man.
Peace, love, and light. You already know.
Say, man. What does the... Look, all this thing right here want us to do, my people. This right here. All this thing right here want us to do. The golden race. Huh? All other races stick together. Puerto Ricans stick with Puerto Ricans. Dominicans stick with Dominicans. Asians stick with Asians. Arabs stick with Arabs. The Europeans stick with Europeans. Why ain't the honeybees sticking together? Huh? The honeybees are sticking with the wasps, the carpenter bees, the fucking dog, the motherfucking, the hornet wasps, everyone else but the honeybee. Huh? Why? Why we ain't sticking the fuck together? Huh? Why? The blood runs, huh? And we going through the lion. Listen, listen, hold up. It might be grinding my body. Hold up. I'm sorry, Riz. I apologize, Riz. People be grinding Bob Marley up, right? I want y'all to understand Bob Marley's songs was talking science. Go listen to his songs. Even what he talking right now. He said, they said our blood. I told you every natural animal on this planet, natural, has your DNA in it, but you don't have its DNA in you. We don't have any animal blood. None. None. And they say that the lion has our blood running through it. And then you go look at how they treat the lion. Go look at how this European Asian race and the Arab race treat the lion as opposed to their dog. Huh? Go look. Go look at the Sumerian text. The fucking Sumerian god got the lion by the neck. Got the lion by the fucking neck. And got one picture, he got the lion hanging upside down by his foot, by his ankles.
Giant.
Huh? The giant had the lion hanging upside down by his ankles. Huh? And y'all talking some Asian race, some Arab race? I'm talking this motherfucker right here. This motherfucker right here. That's what I'm talking about. And I want to thank Riz for letting me coming on this show because I can't go live, my people, and I don't feel right. And they knew what the fuck they was doing. I don't feel right just making videos and putting them up here. So I thank Riz for allowing me to use his platform and to share about 15 minutes of my soul with y'all.
Get it in,
just
bro.
To share 15 minutes of my soul with y'all, man. Seriously, I want to show y'all, man. I'm gonna show y'all right here. Listen, this boy David Wilcox, man. Hold on. Let me get over here.
What Bob's saying, the blood runs.
Listen, they say the blood runs.
And it runs through our loins.
Runs through our loins. And guess what? We passing through the lion's gate right now.
All day long.
Through the lion's gate right now. We are passing through that. Huh? This is why the energy is changing on this planet. This is why this entity is ramping up all of this negativity shit on this planet. You see the black family face down on the ground, the hot ass sun, all the cops over. How you mistaken a van for a stolen bike?
A motorcycle.
Come on, God. How you mistaken my van for a stolen motorcycle?
Yeah.
What the fuck? I got five people on a motorcycle. I'm in the van, huh? And got my brothers and sisters face down concrete, huh? They wanna listen. I told y'all, you better be prepared for them to take an old black woman, an older elderly. You know her vessel is old, but her vessel has aged, but her soul is ancient. It's forever. They are liable to take an old black woman that's on a breathing machine, on a wheelchair. They are liable to hang her on TV, shoot her up, and set her on fire. Cuz this is where we at right now. This motherfucker is going to use everything it can. Mm-hmm. They are over. They are over. And it's past the artificial race. These things already come out of the fucking ground, y'all. Listen, you don't know, believe how hot I said this before. The surface of the earth underneath your feet is hotter than underneath your feet is hotter than the surface. And your upper atmosphere is hotter than the surface of the earth. That's why the planes are flying lower. That's why when you see the skies purple, orange, that's radiation. They can't stay the fuck up there. Only us can go the fuck up there. That's why they say the sky's the limit. Ain't no limit with you. Ain't no limit with you. Let me finish this song right here.
Get it.
It's my shit, man. Huh?
And the heart to find. And John saw them coming.
He saw them coming. What? What? What he come with? With the truth. From what? From an ancient time. From an ancient time. Huh?
The brotherly love. The sisterly love. I feel it's morning.
Come on, Riz. Come on, my brother. Come on. See, this is a celebration time. This ain't time for fear. This is celebration, cuz. What the fuck, cuz? I'm ready for this shit. Shut all this shit down. And God we trust have to die. When y'all gonna get that through y'all fucking minds, huh? In God we trust have to die. So think of everything that is linked to in God we trust. Think about everything that is linked. Your school, your education department, your political, your justice system, your entertainment. They're hanging on by their fucking strings, huh? Hanging on by their fucking strings. Let me give you an example of some bullshit. You know them motherfuckers don't like baseball. Motherfuckers rather watch grass grow. But go look at the Roman Colosseums in Rome. Go look at the Roman Colosseums and go look at the football stadiums. Huh? You want to tell me I got to practice 6 feet for my brother? Huh? When we sitting down on the benches, and when we talking to coaches, but I'm sweating. I'm running up and down a motherfucking court. Huh? The first organ on your body, the number one defense on your body is your skin. Your skin is a fucking organ.
Biggest one in the body.
When you scratch yourself, you don't tell your skin to repair. You got cell memory. It's called cell regeneration. That shit works on its own. On its fucking own. So you mean to tell me my pores are open? I'm playing basketball with my brother, dunking up for you, entertaining you fucking monkeys. You understand? But you talk about COVID-19. Huh? Now you got my football players. Now you got my brothers. You got my brothers on a football field in your Roman Colosseums. In your Roman Colosseums. Huh? In the age of a lion. You got my lions. Huh? Go look in a zoo as a difference between a lion and a zoo and look at how his mane look as opposed to a lion that's out in the fucking wild. Huh? The nigga in the zoo, his shit fluffy. His shit fluffy. Y'all like the motherfucker get manicures all the time. Huh? He get manicures all the time.
Soft
as shit. That's why they say when an animal is in captivity, he can't make it in the wild. He wouldn't know what the fuck to do. Huh? His shit fluffy. Go pull it up and look. His shit all fluffy. Oh, he cute. Huh? The one in the wild, his shit look beautiful. His shit look beautiful. Huh? Beautiful. You understand? The one in the, you'll be looking at him in the cage, you'll be like, damn. But then the one in the loud, you hear him. Hum, hum, hum. You just hear him. Hum. Hmm, you know what I'm saying? And they like, damn, listen to that vibrational tone from that lion. And we have gotten soft with the European accent. That's all. Or when a brother speak like this, he angry. How the fuck am I angry? I never said I wanted to enslave anyone. I love my people, man. I love my motherfucking people. And you know what's so sad? It's because I was a mental slave, and this is all about mental slavery. And but because I know how deep the rabbit hole go, this is why I push so motherfucking hard. I push so motherfucking hard. You got my brothers in these motherfucking coliseums, and we sending out this energy ignorantly, not even knowing. Not even knowing. Meanwhile, search up crop circles of 2020 and see how many crop circles your higher selves have been leaving on this planet. But yet, we think that there was a war in heaven. We believe that there was, hold on. Thank you, Red. Just thank you, brother. I want to thank y'all. Let me calm down a little bit, y'all. Y'all see me, I'm over here going and my energy flowing.
Yes, sir.
Listen, we think it was a war in heaven, man. There was no war. You understand? Understand something. There was no war. Please, my people, understand this. If I took over a planet, why would I let you come in and drop crop circles? Why would I let you do that? Huh? You have to have some significant power to do that. More than what I got. So this is what takes me back to saying that this was a test. This was a pure test. And I want to play a video real quick. Let me play a video real quick. And I keep telling y'all, the number one thing is, look at your DNA. Look at your DNA. Now, this is David Wilcox. If those brothers and sisters that are not familiar with David Wilcox, I suggest you go pull up Ancient Aliens and go get caught up. Because I can tell you, if you watch Ancient Aliens Pyramids, Ancient Aliens Significant Number 9, or the...
Here's a matching YouTube result.
Look at this shit here. Popping up without me even saying nothing. Look at this. This has been going on consistently.
Yeah, phone. Artificial intelligence.
And I got it. Listen, you don't even... Never mind. But anyway, you go watch Ancient Aliens, Crop Circles, Ancient Aliens, Pyramids, Ancient Aliens, Pyramids and Crop Circles. Just go watch that. And Pioneer Gland. Go watch that. The secrets of that. But I'm going to play this, right? And I'm gonna intervene with this. And I want to show y'all, I want to let y'all understand something. That this has been going on, as I stated for, and go check my videos from when I first started. I didn't go into no books or nothing. I looked at our DNA. And if you are that, your DNA is what God is. This is how powerful you are. Whatever God is and whatever God can do that this entity believe, this is what you can do. You built this planet. As much as I can tell, I keep saying it over and over. You built this planet in a different avatar. In a different avatar. Here we go. And you put yourself through this test. You gotta understand how powerful this test is. For you to be in your lower self and rise to your higher self in hell, and then for them to be in their higher selves to know that they can wipe out this shit at any point in time, my people. And how I know that this entity is up against the ropes and is a reactive entity, it shows itself all the time. Peep the move. Ask yourself, who's really shutting down the ecosystem? Who's really flooding China, Europe, Russia, and Asia? Who's really doing that? Who's really doing that? Huh? Because guess what this entity is doing? Shutting down the farms with fake virus. Making farmers kill their, what? Calves? What else?
Yeah. Chickens, pigs.
Chickens, killing them.
Everything.
Telling delivery trucks don't deliver them. Yep. None of that.
Don't pick up the milk.
None of that. Dumping that shit. Go search it up.
Yeah.
Go search this shit up. This is fact. Farmers are outright speaking about this shit. Potatoes saying, why can't we deliver this? At all. Now you tell me, who's shutting what down? Huh? They are reacting to our higher selves. And a lot of us down here are reacting in this third dimension to this motherfucking low dimensional being. That's all. Once you unplug and see what it really is, then you'll be able to see the whole game. You'll be able to pull away from the script. Donald Trump on TV, as I stated to you before, people be like, yo, you support Donald Trump? Listen, I don't care who the warden of the prison is. That shit don't make no bit of difference. I'm telling you to listen for the codes that he's trying to tell you. I'm not listening to him to survive or none of that. I'm listening to him to know that I know that this motherfucker is under threat. I know that he's playing both sides, and I know that this shit is over. Period. When he outright stated that he tweeted out of all those doctors that was sitting at the podium, he tweeted that black particular doctor, that black queen, that sister. He could have tweeted any of those doctors. All of those doctors knew what she was talking about. And the white doctor, if you notice, she was smiling and happy that she was speaking about this shit. that the black woman is under attack by witches and demons. You think of witches and demons as some shit on TV or to some old spell. You don't understand. Because you're just looking at yourself as the only intelligent being on this planet, and you don't understand the power of vernacular or words. You don't even understand that. The power of thought, that's a problem. We don't understand that as whole, because things we feel is moving on a slow level. Like shit, you want shit instantaneous. Like shit, I want a Bentley right in front of me. And we think about materialistic shit. I want a Bentley. And you just, I wish on a pot of gold that I want $1 million. All materialistic shit. And all of the shit that they creating for you came from the fucking earth. It's less than you.
Yes.
Less than you. So I got this fly in here. I don't know how I got in here, but I keep looking at him. But I want to play this video, my people. I'm going to interject, and then Riz going to get into his thing and his pictures. I appreciate you getting Riz for letting me use your platform, my people.
Go in, bro.
I love y'all, man. I say it sincerely, dude. I want y'all. I want to just drive my point home. Listen to this. They don't want they don't want black people to look into your DNA. This is all about the sun and the sun people on this planet.
So what do I mean when I'm talking about the cabal? One of the names that many people are familiar with would be the Bilderbergers, the Trilateral Commission, the Council on Foreign Relations, the New World Order, the Illuminati.
Now, the Illuminati, the word just means enlightened one. That's just all it is, enlightened one. It does not mean some satanic. Everything that they took out of the walls and out of those tombs of Egypt, they have reversed it and made it evil, my people. But it's not. They're using you against you.
What are we really talking about here? Ultimately, we are talking about organized crime. We are talking about crime syndicates that work on a quasi-governmental level because they do not take any of their high-ranking people and actually run them for office. The people who run for office are never more than middle level within these corporations. We have multiple insiders, whistleblowers, some of whom I've spoken to directly, who have witnessed American presidents acting like simpering little wimps in front of these higher-ranking cabal members, because they are terrified of them. This cabal has at its core, believe it or not, a Luciferian belief system. You say to yourself, who in the world would possibly want to construct a religion around Lucifer? Well, it's very clever. It works like this. You have ancient mystery school teachings, and the ancient mystery school teachings date back to the legendary civilization of Atlantis, which is real. We now know, for example, these ruins.
Now, remember when I told y'all we're not from Africa? This has nothing to do with my African brothers and sisters. I love you. But the people in America, we're not from Africa. So I want y'all to understand this. Atlantis and Antarctica was way before Africa. Actually, they all was built simultaneously. You have to understand, after thousands of years, see, let me just say this again, my people, this didn't take 25,000 years. This didn't take 30, 60, 40, or I mean, 100. This has been going on for over 400,000 years. This is what you must understand, for over 400,000 years. And he's going to get into this.
Turkey, Göbekli Tepe, are at least 13,000 years old, because we've carbon dated the dirt that these stone circles were dug out of, and we know they've been buried for 13,000 years. We can no longer deny that, in fact, there are ancient stone monuments that predate any civilizations that we normally know of here on Earth. And the problem is that whoever built these pyramids had the whole civilization, the technology to build it, right out of the box. We don't see a gradual progression where we're looking for shards of pottery, and we're trying to find how we can retrace the footsteps
right
of a civilization that takes the necessary thousands of years to build up to the point where it could do highly technological
right
acts
out the box.
Right. And in other words, he's stating that there was a civilization of race, a race of people that were here, intelligent beings that were already equipped.
And no evidence of no Stone Age shit, just out the box high level technology.
And built and created shit and then disappeared. Mm-hmm. Now, guess where we can find these people at? Guess where we can find, if you can't find their remains, guess where you can find these motherfucking people at? Huh? In the black woman's DNA. In her fucking DNA. She has the whole race of people that's not even on this fucking planet. Where do they go? Who are they? Are they gods? Are they fucking gods? Huh? Hold on. Let me get back over here. And again, this is what you would call metagenes. The red box is all we are active to, my people. This is it. This is it. So when you talk about building structures as opposed to building the space station that can only orbit, what the fuck is going on? You people, they can't even begin to touch you. Meta. This is why this was a test. This is what I'm trying to explain to y'all. This is how you test Superman and Superwoman. This is how you make us better. This is how you make us better. You listen, you ever see a motherfucker that's complacent with life in any aspect? Just understand something. And then a motherfucker that want to do more in life. I don't care, any aspect. Let's just say somebody that's in a job that was like, all right, I'm a banker, but I want to move up to be a manager. The motherfucker doing everything he can to be a manager. But the motherfucker that's content at being a worker, you don't say, just sit there. Just age, just moving along with life. A person that want to work out as opposed to someone that actually works out. This is the difference. That's it. This is what I'm trying to explain to you, my people. I love you. But we are all, you strip away our greatness and you make us depend and rely on us, on each other. And then you leave nothing but breadcrumbs on this planet, whereas though it's not enough, there's so much information here that they could never destroy it and disconnect you because you have left so much. And the next time we go through this test, you know how advanced we are? We're going to create different shit in nature to say, okay, next time we're going to leave this because we already know where we fell at when the Earth, again, Earth is a spaceship, it traveled throughout the cosmos. We already know what point, our higher self know what point we fell at, where we got disconnected at. We already know that point. So we like, all right, we got to build something to get past this point. We got to build something to get past this point. This is how we get greater. Just sitting around doing fucking nothing don't make you great. Come on.
Has been able to build pyramid-like structures with those large blocks of stone with today's technology. The largest cranes in the world can't lift them. The Japanese tried to do it at 1/5 scale and they completely failed. They could not build a Great Pyramid replica at only 1/5 the size.
Wow. You can't replicate it. Highly duplicate it, but never replicate it. Understand that, black woman and black man, colored woman. You're highly replicated all through artificial intelligence. Your cell phone, the clock, the TV, everything, 12 strands of DNA, everything represents your genetic makeup.
Yep,
everything.
The computer, the car, the airplane,
everything represents your genetic makeup. They can't create nothing new without you.
So somebody had advanced technology. The implication is that this technology was not local to Earth, but that this was a refugee group or multiple refugee groups who actually came to Earth, perhaps on the run from a cosmic battle of some kind.
Now, this is where I always tell y'all, you have to use your own discernment. You have to use your own discernment when it comes to this right here, my people. Again with the battle, if it was such a battle, why is it so easy for them to change Earth in 7 years? The tribulation started September 23rd of 2017. It took this entity over 400,000 years to get us in this condition. Why is it only going to take us 7 years to turn it back? Tell me, is that true power or not? True power.
And in fact, this is the occult secret story of Lucifer, the fallen angel. And in fact, there is a secret book that was withheld from the Bible called the Book of Enoch. And in the Book of Enoch, what you hear about is a race of cannibalistic giants who crash landed on Earth and are called the fallen angels. And they are, in fact, eating people here on Earth, but they're twice our size.
Mm-hmm.
They were ordered not to reproduce with the women of Earth, but they did anyway. And what ends up happening is that the women give birth to this new race that they call Nephilim. And this...
Now, the women that they genetically modified gave birth to a new race called the Nephilim. Now, when y'all look up the word Nephilim in Hebrew, y'all better understand what the word Nephilim, it means fallen one. When they say fallen one, it has nothing to do with a fallen angel. It means someone that will do savagery shit. That's what it means. I will eat you. That's what the fallen one means. Now, listen. Go search up Basque people that are located between France and Spain. Rh negative and Rh positive people. They can't even reproduce with each other without a Rogaine shot. And every president of the United States is Rh positive and is related to each other. And they all are related to Dracula. That Dracula individual is a real life individual. And all your presidents are related and all of them are connected. All of them are related and related to that guy, Dracula, who's up in Europe. It's connected to the royal family.
Vlad the Impaler.
Exactly.
Vlad Tepes.
Now tell me, what did Dracula eat? Dracula didn't eat nothing.
Drink blood.
Thank you. Because life is in the blood.
All day long.
Like, and how many stories did you need to hear about cannibalism and about them drinking blood?
Didn't the giants and Jack and the Beanstalk ate the blood of the Englishman? Come on. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Like, what? It's all symbolism.
They all symbolism. Telling you.
Crazy.
It's mirrored in the book of Genesis, but the book of Enoch has a lot more in there. And we now know that this is a genuine, authenticated ancient text because independent copies that say the same thing and have been backdated have been found in Ethiopia and other places, such as by the Scottish historian Sir Robert Bruce, going way back to the 1700s.
Fly, killing me, people.
So this book explains that a group of people came here from somewhere else with advanced technology.
Now listen, these people came here. We put them here. We put these people here. This is where the test started.
And that they did in fact set up control systems here on Earth.
And you know what movie talks about this? I can't think of what movie it is. But it's Transformers. When the African people, in the beginning of the movie, when the African people was climbing over the rocks and shit, people that watch Transformers, listen, they just don't watch it for entertainment. In the movie Transformers, the African people was climbing over the rocks and they was looking over the rocks. At that time, they made it look like we were like Shaka Zulu, but we were really in our higher self. The planet was beautiful. It was amazing. It was spectacular. And we saw them. This is what I'm trying to tell you. We saw them. We communicated. We talked to these. It's way more of us than it is them. We saw them.
No doubt. The Book of Enoch is a predecessor to Genesis, which also has Noah's Ark and the flood. In fact, Enoch is Noah's grandfather. So what appears to have happened is that this great flood was authorized. The Atlantean flood wiped out the civilization of Atlantis because Atlantis was a colony. It was not native people that had originated here on Earth. It was a...
We are not from Earth. Kalai say this to you all the time. We are not from here. We are not... It's why you think it's certain individuals speaking up. That's all I'm trying to say. And speaking passionately about this shit.
A civilization that had transplanted itself here. And when they came here, they brought with themselves all of their books, all of their ancient texts that go back 500,000 years, the full record of their civilization. Now that, those texts.
Now hold on, let me rewind this a little bit. Came here over 500,000 years ago, build up shit, and supposedly left.
Noah's Ark and the flood. In fact, Enoch is Noah's grandfather. So what appears to have happened is that this great flood was authorized. The Atlantean flood wiped out the civilization of Atlantis because Atlantis was a colony. It was not native people that had originated here on Earth. It was a vast civilization that had transplanted itself here. And when they came here, they brought with themselves all of their books, all of their ancient texts that go back 500,000 years, the full record of their civilization. Now that, those texts were stored in the Library of Alexandria in Egypt because some of these people did survive the flood. And then the Romans sacked and burned the Library of Alexandria, but before they burned it, they took out all the good stuff and they relocated.
Now, if y'all know who Alexander is, y'all, you know, the Greek, y'all understand that. Y'all know what happened. They, after that, after we taught y'all everything, you understand? After we taught them everything, we built schools to teach them, but they could never learn the shit they was begging to learn. Like, they could never grasp their minds around our teachings. We were too advanced. We had to dumb ourselves down, my people. I'm not going to play this full video. I'm just going to play a little bit more.
The Vatican Library. So I have insiders who have actually sat down with me and described to me going into the Vatican Library and reading books that were made by extraterrestrial civilizations before they ever came here. These books include highly technical diagrams of interstellar spacecraft and gigantic motherships. And these books are very, very ancient. Some of them have Mylar type of pages, very glossy. Some of them are actually holographic. You open them up and this image just comes up and it can show you, it interacts with your consciousness, tells you what you want to hear. Anything you want to know, it'll just show it to you. So you have to understand now that the repository of these documents is in the Vatican. Therefore, there are people who are on a need-to-know basis who actually have access to that knowledge. They understand that they are the descendants of an extraterrestrial race that came.
Hold on, my people. This is what I want y'all to understand, this part right here. Tell me what they're doing with the live. Are they cutting it off? See, I told y'all, they're going to have to fuck with this shit here, cuz, because I'm giving this a sauce. This is sauce. I told y'all, cuz.
Yo.
Listen.
They fucking with us, bro.
Listen, y'all watch other videos. I have nothing against my brothers as we want to go into these books and go into the, you know what I mean, want to walk down the street and march with guns. But I'm going to tell you right now, you fucking watch Collab O'Riz video, fuck going to go grab a gun. You going to go grab some chlorophyll and go outside and high-five the fucking sun. That's what you going to go do. That's real shit, cuz. That's real shit. And then you going to spit UV dreadful. UV fucking listen, me and Riz and BJ's today, right? Let me tell y'all what happened.
Oh yeah, tell them, bro.
Yo, today. Listen, today in BJ's, I told y'all we prepping. So I go out to go get one of the flatbed carts, right? Now the Asian man and the Asian woman, the young boy and his mom, they stop at the door with both of their carts, right in the middle of the big door. They just stop. Stopped in the middle of the door, put their gloves on. They seen a whole bunch of people right there trying to come in the door. They just stopped, disregard everyone that was behind them, put their gloves on, put their mask on. Mind you, the sun beaming, they got hats on their head, and she got sunglasses. I'm like, excuse me. I'm like, y'all could have went in and pulled to the side. So as I go in, me and Riz go over to the water. He comes over to the water, look me right in my face as I'm picking the water up, right? And I look at him. He said, what you looking at? I said, nigga, evolution. That's what the fuck. I'm trying to figure out how the fuck did they make you? Yeah. Yeah. He immediately face changed. He thought I was going to come back at him on some gangster shit. How the fuck did they make you, dude? Like, you, your country is dying. The sun is burning you off of the fucking head. Riz, like, wait a minute.
I'm looking at a monkey.
I'm looking at a fucking monkey, bro. I'm telling you, how the fuck did they make you? This is you are brilliant.
Wow. Yeah, I stepped right in the middle, like, bro, just take it easy, bro. Don't even worry about it. Boy was mumbling like, oh man.
Yo, he's
he was so mad. I said, bro, just let it go, bro.
Truth. You on my planet. You don't even belong here. What am I looking at? Bro, evolution. That's what the fuck I'm, how the fuck did they, dude, like, really? Yeah. I'm looking, that's how I'm looking at, and I look at all of them like that when I start talking to them, like, even the cops. How the fuck did they, yo, dude, do you not understand? Yo, you are the scientists that put, my people, this is what I'm saying, think about it. Yo, they use different DNA to make a living organism. What the fuck, cuz? Yo, look at your dog. Look at your neighbor dog. That motherfucker ain't real. It don't belong here.
Yeah,
yo.
It's a genetic mutation. It's been spliced together. I mean, look at all the new breed of dogs. They have like the pit bull bully breeds, the double XL pit bulls. These dogs are bred with different strains of dog to give you a new breed. You know what I mean? They'll take a bulldog and mate it with a pit bull and then give you a new breed of animal. And this is what's been going on.
And my people, This is what I'm saying. This has been going on in nature. This has been going on with fruits and vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
And this is going on with the human race. Mm-hmm. This is why I'm telling you this was a test.
All genetic.
This was a test. I'm going to play a little bit more, and then we're going to go on the Riz picture because I got to get up in the morning, my people. I love y'all.
By extraterrestrial civilizations before they ever came here. These books include highly technical diagrams of interstellar spacecraft and gigantic motherships. And these books are very, very ancient. Some of them have Mylar type of pages, very glossy. Some of them are actually holographic. You open them up and this image just comes up.
Now, go look at Iron Man and all those videos, those sci-fi movies. They push this shit. Where you think they... Yo, my people, see, this is what makes me want to cry.
Yeah.
How could something only access 5-7% of their brain come up with this shit, cuz?
Black Panther showed it hard, too.
Yo, how could they do it?
The technology.
It's
in written record that the so-called original man, the black man and woman, civilized the whole entire world with sanitation, sterilization, education, just everything you love in your modern life. I mean, down to school systems, the way the roads are fashioned, the tar on the streets, everything. It all comes from we. Understand that. So, see, they hide that from you so you don't know how great you are.
Mm-hmm. It's crazy. Hold on. Now, let me play, a little bit more, but I had to cut that part off, man. And listen, they don't want a certain race of people on this planet to know that they are extraterrestrial, meaning that they are extra and they are on a terrain. That's it. You don't belong here. That's all it is. Earth is a school.
Extraterrestrial civilizations before they ever came here. These books include highly technical diagrams of interstellar spacecraft and gigantic motherships. And these books are very, very ancient. Some of them have Mylar type of pages, very glossy. Some of them are actually holographic. You open them up and this image just comes up and it can show you, interact with your consciousness, tells you what you want to hear. Anything you want to know, it'll just show it to you. So you have to understand now that the repository of these documents is in the Vatican. Therefore, there are people who are on a need-to-know basis who actually have access to that knowledge. They understand that they are the descendants of an extraterrestrial race that came here that had elongated skulls. And you look at the images of the Egyptian pharaohs, like Akhenaten, like Nefertiti, like their daughter Meretaten, and what you see is this highly elongated skull. We have scientists like Brian Forster who are in Peru, and Brian Forster is actually finding new examples of these skulls with elongated craniums. And whereas the normal human skull has two fissures, these only have one.
Listen, search up fissures with the brain in your skull, my people. Search it up. Just search it up. Like I said, your anatomy is amazing. And this is why we had hair wraps, especially when we started going through these phases, because the queens wore hair wraps. Because you have no idea, queen, you were your mind. They had to rip your mind away. How advanced you are. No man should have more insight than you. That's just real. That's real shit. This is what this lockdown is happening for. This is what this lockdown is happening. And queens that are eating healthy, your insight has dramatically increased. You see what's taking place now, and you see what's going to take place, and you see what's going to take place afterwards. You ain't got no fear. You ready. You ready for this shit.
Have all kinds of anomalous features, including we have these nerve plexes that come out of our jaw here, whereas they have it at the back of their head. These do not appear to be anything having to do with head binding. So the point is, elongated skulls show up all over the world. They have been found in Boskop, South Africa. They have been found in Siberia. There are graves of royalty in France that have been dug up in which they have elongated skulls. Elongated skulls have been found in North America and South America. They are literally worldwide. And so what we're really dealing with, and I write about this in my new book, The Ascension Mysteries, the whole second half of the book, 250 pages, is a comprehensive diagram of the 500,000-year history of these people, where they started, how they got here, how they turned into the cabal. So it literally does appear, as strange as this must sound, that there are people with extraterrestrial physiology, elongated skulls. Some of them have lost the elongated skulls. Others still have them. And if they still have them, they wear these mitre hats that you see in the Vatican. Ooh. You never take those hats off. So
did we just show that last time we went live on the sun?
Come on.
The female entity was wearing a mitre hat, bro.
Come on.
And you mentioned that. That's the hat they wear in the Vatican.
They wear it. They don't have elongated skulls, but they wear that shit to represent you.
Yeah, symbolism.
Somebody had an elongated skull under that hat. It does sound really bizarre, but just imagine now that you tell a group of people secretly that they are the descendants of an extraterrestrial race that were the gods, that had many tens of IQ points higher in intelligence than everyone else on Earth, that spread themselves out across the world, that became the prevailing ruling caste everywhere.
Wow.
They had advanced technology when they first got here that allowed them to circumnavigate the globe, to build pyramids, to build elaborate structures. Wow. Not all the pyramids were built by negatives.
Say it again.
But there are some that were. And they effectively.
But wait a minute.
Perhaps that you see in the
Vatican. Hold on, let me rewind it for the people in the back.
So you couldn't.
Can you imagine that this truth right here came out to the world? Motherfuckers, you think motherfuckers is getting on their knees saying, we're sorry now. Repent. Yo, listen, cuz. Yo. If this shit came out, and this is why they want you in the house. This is why all that shit is taking place. But they can't stop it because the frequency has changed. Awareness has heightened across the planet. Even Trump is ready to get on his fucking knees and be like, yo, y'all, we fucking with the wrong people, guys. Seriously. 98% of the people you see on TV and in Hollywood are not who you think they are. I'm surrounded by lizards. My family in trouble. Fuck it. I'm playing out of script. That's it.
If somebody had an elongated skull under that hat. It does sound really bizarre, but just imagine now that you tell a group of people.
Listen, Golden Race, this is you. Because I told you, this took place over 400,000 years. Over 400,000 years. Listen, Golden Race.
Secretly. That they are the descendants of an extraterrestrial race that were the gods, that had many tens of IQ points higher in intelligence than everyone else on Earth, that spread themselves out across the world, that became the prevailing ruling caste everywhere. They had advanced technology when they first got here that allowed them to circumnavigate the globe, to build pyramids, to build elaborate structures. Not all the pyramids were built by negatives, but there are some that were.
Oh, rewind that so people can hear.
There are people with extraterrestrial physiology, elongated skulls. Some of them have lost the elongated skulls. Others still have them. And if they still have them, they wear these mitre hats that you see in the Vatican. You never take those hats off. So you couldn't tell if somebody had an elongated skull under that hat. It does sound really bizarre, but just imagine now that you tell a group of people secretly that they are the descendants of an extraterrestrial race that were the gods, that had many tens of IQ points higher in intelligence than everyone else on Earth, that spread themselves out across the world, that became the prevailing ruling caste everywhere. They had advanced technology when they first got here that allowed them to circumnavigate the globe, to build pyramids, to build elaborate structures. Not all the pyramids were built by negatives, but there are some that were. And they effectively created dominion over the Earth. They have been defeated by what we call the Elohim, these positive extraterrestrials you hear about in the Bible and other religious texts, again and again. The Elohim have caused mass catastrophes to happen, Sodom and Gomorrah being another example.
All right, I'm done with that, y'all. I just wanted to play. I know y'all probably wanted to hear the rest of that, but I want Riz to get into these pictures. Like I told you, everything is caused by energy, and the energy that we put out, my people, it comes back on us. Just think about a movie I always like to bring up is what's the movie? Demolition Man. You know what's her name? The white chick in there.
Sandra Bullock.
Sandra Bullock. What did Sandra Bullock always kept saying? She said, and look what color, look at what she was dressed in. All black. They always do it. Mm-hmm. But look what she said. I want some action. She just kept asking for some motherfucking action.
Yeah.
It was too peaceful for her.
Yeah.
She kept saying, I want some action.
It was no crime.
It was no crime. Everybody was hunky-dory, happy. She was like, man, what I wouldn't do for just some action. And then guess what? We got action. Yo, I laugh at this shit, bro, because it's funny when you unplug from the matrix and you look at it, but it's heartbroken too, because Like, you like, damn, I wanted all of us to pass this motherfucking test. You see what I'm saying to you? I don't want to leave no stone turned behind, leave behind or unturned. You know what I mean? That's how I feel. I mean that from my fucking heart. But this shit was a test. Come on, let me get into these pictures, people. Hold on. Which one you want to go with?
To the explosion Johns first from Beirut. Listen, y'all. Right. I see y'all in the chat. They saying they cutting us off. They taking it from like 2-something. It was like 3:40-something back to 2-something. Don't even worry about it. Like, you know.
Man, that's fucked up.
Yeah, I mean, you know. It's
we do it again.
Yeah, it's ugly. You know, we already know. The all gremlins right. are ripped.
Hold on. Where the pictures at?
You sent
it to me? Mm-hmm. Hold on. It should be in here. Hold on, my people. Let me pull these pictures up real fast. All right, here we go. Right here. Mm-hmm. Which one you want to
start with? Right at the top.
This one.
Mm-hmm. Okay, my people. They keep cutting us off. It's okay.
Yo, listen, I told you I was going like, they cut me from live all the way until October the 19th. Go look at Mr. I tell y'all, I don't have no problem with sharing no videos. Go look at Mr. MB33 channel. Go look at his channel, my people. Go see what's taking place. As a matter of fact, I'm going to show you one scene from Mr. MV33 channel. I'm going to show you one fucking scene. Y'all have no idea what's taking place. We're being watched on a day-to-day basis. We are being watched.
Damn, they say y'all freezing, y'all cutting everything. It's not us, folks.
Yeah, definitely it is.
We are up and running over here. Everything is crispy and clear.
Not this one you said, yeah, right?
Yeah, start like we're going to go right now.
All right. Oh, hold on. Here you go, my people. This is what red. All right, we go.
Yeah. Now this is from the giant explosion over in Beirut, Lebanon. This is the massive ship that was over top of the city. Mm. I mean, you could just look at it. We're going to shoot to the next picture. Like, massive craft. You're going to tell me that's a cloud?
And that explosion destroyed the economy completely.
Totally.
Even though y'all see the economy shutting down.
They talking about, oh, it's an accident. It was an accident. Okay. From what I see, I seen aircraft flying through there, dropping things and flying in and around it.
Yup.
And they wasn't regular aircraft. Now I put this on community post. When I first looked at this, I said, damn, that looked like Marcus Garvey. Like a giant military hat that he used to wear, his nose, his mouth, his eye. I'll zoom in on it, and then we'll show you the picture of Marcus Garvey. And look at the colors on that. I see like purple, green, red, yellow, black. Shit is crazy. Why would a smoke cloud be making an image in the face of Marcus Garvey?
Marcus Garvey spoke of separation. They don't never bring him up. They only want to talk about Martin Luther King. Marcus Garvey spoke of separation. We were throbbing.
And we're going to pull the picture up of Marcus Garvey right now to show you. While that's fresh in your memory. And there's Marcus Garvey right there. See that?
Oh, let me see if I can put this picture.
Matches up perfectly.
Hold on, my people. Just so we can match it up for y'all even better. I'm gonna do it here. There you go.
Oh yeah, that's love, bro.
Hold on. My bad. Here we go, my people.
Telling you, it's a vibration. You see it for yourself. Yeah, some music, come on.
Yeah, come on.
Quiet in here, you know. Look at that, y'all. Match up perfectly. Look like Marcus Garvey. That's ridiculous. And don't worry, I know they messing with this chat. They don't want this type of truth out. You know, some people think it's crazy, but you can think whatever you want.
Basically,
I'm showing you some real deal stuff, and I'm making shit happen, and I'm telling you, and we're telling you what's going on. If you've been riding with us this whole time, like, I mean, we shooting 10 for 10 right now.
9-9-9.
There it is.
Domain.
You feel me, bro?
Fibonacci. 9-9-9.
Straight up.
Yes. Easy, not to eat.
Yeah, man. We got a good one.
All right. Here we go. Mm-hmm.
That's the one there, so. short shift.
Oh yeah.
There you go. And this next shot right here, you can see one of the ships over top of the giant plume of smoke that's in the image of Marcus Garvey. This flew into it and out of it.
Live if you wanna live.
Just zoom out for perspective, and there it is. That's the explosion, and you see it flew out right there. Ships flying all around the explosion, folks. The news ain't telling you that. And if you watch the video, you'll see. Yeah, you'll see the objects.
Yup.
Flying around. It's not debris. The massive ship again, and the melanated being that's standing on top of the ship. Understand, this ship right here is over top of the city, and it's bigger than Beirut. I got a wider angle to show you it for perspective. So this is not small stuff up here. I'm gonna zoom in on the entity right here. With the head cover on, the melanated face, garment, and everything. Reaching out here on the outside of the craft. You see the shoulders, you know what I mean? The clothing,
yep.
The headdress, the color of the skin, you see everything. You feel me? And this is from the explosion in Beirut. This is the shit that nobody see. But that's why we are here. To bring it to you live. And the hate is real because y'all telling me.
Oh, what a new day. Uh-huh. They gotta keep this motherfucker on. I be giving up that energy, man, on these lives, man.
He told me before we started, he said, Ritz, I'm gonna go in so hard, bro. They're gonna want to shut your channel down. I said, let's do it.
No question. He was like, I don't care, let's ride. That's what we do.
That's what we do. Yeah. Like 3-4 craft came out of the smoke. You see him circle. I seen a lot of angles of this explosion. Mobby 777 had one like less than an hour after it happened. I had a little short video and I captured everything, but I put it on my community. But this thing right here, they were talking to people that lived in Beirut their whole life that witnessed IED explosion, car bombs, terrorists, you know, attacks. They said they never saw an explosion like that ever. That's something that was new to them.
Yup.
Understand that. Don't worry. They hating on us. So it's cool, Faden. Oh, could you go back to the explosion?
Which one? Oh, this one? Oh, uh-huh. Ooh, I forgot about ooh.
Yeah, and you see what's up. This is from the explosion again. A manifestation of a woman's face with an afro. I'm zooming on the face, so, you know, seeing is believing. Ain't that right, Matlock Soap? Seeing is believing. Wildfire Penny, love.
What's up, Wildfire? I know y'all ready for this time. I know Riz asked me, he said, when you said you wanted to shut down, he like, what you mean? I said, in God we trust. Everything shut the fuck down.
Mm-hmm.
Everything. We don't even understand, my people. Like, we look at those that are stuck in this world. You have to separate yourself from them because they see nothing but disaster with all the stores closing, with all the COVID-19, with the Black Lives Matter, with all the rioting, with the coin shortage now. They just see destruction. You understand? I see the death of a false god and Satan. That's what I see. I should be living off the earth. Guess what? The people that live in Africa in villages, none of this shit is going to affect them other than earthquakes and floods or the rain. Other than that, the hunger, the violence, and all that shit ain't affecting people that's already living off the earth. This is why I'm telling you, those people are the ones that are going to be in trouble. And people gonna get mad at me but I don't give a fuck because people on my channel, they swear it's all about the woman. But I'm gonna say this. This is for all the women that like that song Beyonce. All the independent women, throw your hands in the air. Let me explain something to you. I guarantee you, when this shit hit the motherfucking fan, you gonna want a lion in that motherfucking den with you. See, right now, you cool with the independent woman shit because you could call 911 when shit hit the fan. But guess what? You ain't been watching Donald Trump commercials? If there is a murder, press one. Yeah.
If there's a rape, press two. Home invasion, press three. For all other crimes, it'll be a 5-day waiting period.
Right. Yeah. And I want y'all to understand something. See, and then the cocky ones, the women, the ones that's independent and the cocky ones that don't want to deal with reality, going to say, well, I got me a motherfucking gun. See, let me explain something to you. When you go to the shooting range, you know it's paper there. The motherfucker ain't shooting back. You understand, right? Mm-hmm. We're just like a motherfucker that be, you ever see somebody hit the pads all day? Bah, 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 bah. Nigga
look
get hit
good.
The
pads.
Look good. Nigga get in the ring, got his ass whooped.
With the pressure get on. Like, hold on.
As soon as the motherfucker pressure get, it's a complete difference when you in that situation. Just like a motherfucker can, you would think of somebody that's shooting jump shots all day, can shoot if he make them. But once somebody play defense and get up on that ass, it's a complete different story. So it's either in you or it ain't in you. And I'm not making fun of you because guess what? You're the independent ones and all the guys, the men out here that was fly, that was gangster, that was the, you know what I mean, that was the woman getter. Yo, them oodles and noodles. the motherfucker fly ass Jordans. All them sneaks he got in mama house. All them tight ass motherfucking jeans he got. He done went shopping. Get ready to get another stimulus check. It go even more in. Huh? We'll see. They are made for each other. Back to that one.
Yeah, you keep on.
That's on.
Yeah, we've seen that already. All right. Fire drums.
Right. Oh. So people can get mad at me and say, Kalai, you just talking shit. Call it what you want. I'm not better than no one. You know what I'm saying? I wanna bring you with me so you can put me better and I can put you higher. Same thing. But I'm not gonna deal with no false reality. This world created false egos and motherfuckers. And motherfuckers is gonna pay that had those false fucking egos. I got a bachelor's degree. I got a master's degree. I got my own house. Good. You and that motherfucker by yourself now. You and your fucking cat. What's going to see who died first? You or the cat? Real shit. Who going to die hunger first? Y'all going to get each other nails done. Fuck going on. Yeah, I'm real shit. Get mad at Kalai because I don't come to look at my channels. Don't come on here and talk to me because you say, damn, they got muscles. He talking some old fly. Don't get on that. Listen. I want someone to sharpen me. Steel sharpen steel. I'm being motherfucking real. You understand? Let me tell you how real shit is. A motherfucker told me, and I apologize. I don't want to say that. But a sister said to me with some old fly shit one day, when you gonna knock my root chakra out? I bust the fuck out laughing in my head. You know what I said to her? I said, yo, queen, yo, can you stimulate my mind on something different other than that? Fuck the whole world up. Now, how am I a man? I'm a man that's humping all my, that wanna, supposedly, all we wanna do is this. How am I a fucking man and the women out here fucking more than us? Huh? See, the sisters don't wanna deal with reality. We accept toxicity. We accept toxicity. Nigga, you ain't twerking all motherfucking day long. You want something there. You know what I'm saying? Keep it real with yourselves. Keep it real with your queens out here that y'all call queen. You got royal blood. You want royal accolades. But you ain't acting fucking royalty. You ain't acting royalty. And then when a brother like me or another brother call you out in your unnurturing ass, then you get mad. You get mad. Because the first thing you say, I gave you some bajayjay. Nigga, what the fuck? What? Can I get a back rub? Can I get this motherfucker up and down my back? Huh? Yeah. This right here. Yeah. You understand? Come on.
That lasts longer. You feel
and
me?
That's real shit.
Yeah.
So y'all can kick it how you want. I'm not saying, listen, I love my sisters. I do. I'm saying, but we have condoned egos that are toxic, that are fucking toxic. I don't hang around with brothers that look at ass all day. I don't hang around with brothers that talk about vagina all day. I don't hang around with brothers that don't take care of their fucking kids. I used to. You understand? Because I was like, I can't judge them. I ain't judging them, but I can separate myself from them. That's what the fuck I can do. You feel me?
Yeah.
I ain't gotta say I need you for my friend. I don't need you as my friend when you part of the problem with my entire race.
Wow.
When you part of the problem of my entire race, yeah. You see? Uh-huh. So guess what? When they said only 144 is really the number 9, but 144 out of 7.8 billion people, fuck it. Fuck it. Let it happen. Let it happen. Mm-hmm. Let it happen, because that's who gonna be killing each other out there. The ones that wanted to twerk all day, the ones that wanted to get their car. You guys seen nigga out in the fucking, yo, people, it just got finished raining. This nigga was outside wiping his car down with a Pepsi on top of his car and a cigarette hanging out of his fucking mouth. Now, am I supposed to judge him? No, I'm not judging him. I rolled past him and kept it the fuck moving. How are you expecting? How could you expect God to love you more than you love yourself if there's a fucking God up there? Huh? Huh?
Look.
My bad, Riz.
You going bad, to bro. Get it off, bro. They try to stop us, bro. You know what I mean? This is from the wildfires in Southern California. Crazy. Like, these are living beings. I'm gonna show you. I already had them up. I'm gonna show you the face real quick. Look at that. That's real rap though, bro. What?
Seriously.
See the head, the ear, the eye, the face. I mean, that's an eye, y'all. That's a face. Just take a look at that. It looked like a cartoon. But that's me watching the video of the fire, pausing it, taking a screenshot.
And I'm going to tell y'all, my people, I love you, man. I swear I love you. But those that are aware and those that are prepping, if you fall for that false love shit, I'm going to tell you right now, you are wrong. I don't give a fuck if they family members or not. And I mean that shit. You going to come to my door with 2 packs of oozles and noobs when I told you about this shit already? I'm telling you this shit. Oh, man, you ain't think this shit? You gonna come in with 2 packs of oodles and noodles? Are you out? I'm gonna give you a bottle of water and a lighter, mm-hmm. and shut the fucking door. Something with you.
We're gonna get a book of matches.
Yeah, we need that lighter.
I need my lighter. I need a book of matches. This lighter gonna last me like 40 days, the way I'm gonna use it. What? Everything is like, yo.
And I mean it, people. I love y'all. I sincerely do. Sisters, don't fall for that dumb shit. You in there, just you and your babies. You understand? Don't fall for the, come on, let me in there. You understand? Because if he wasn't prepping and he wasn't prepared, just understand something. He care less about your life than he care about yours, than his. And I'm not putting my brothers down. I'm telling you, this is, we have to look at this shit reality. If somebody say, yo, it's going to be organ harvesting. It's going to be raping out here in the fucking street. It's going to be pure violence out here. A motherfucker be like, yo, I ain't got no rights, yo. Give me a motherfucking baby, and I get you 2 bags of rice. What? What?
Anything.
Anything.
Book of Eli shit.
Come on, man. Yeah. I'm telling, and I'm not, this is not fear-mongering. This is to aware. This is all I'm saying is aware. Like, yo, you know what? I'm not afraid, but Kalal, right? I'm not going to let no motherfucker hear dog. What? Are you serious? No. Uh-uh. He's right. That don't make sense. You know what I mean? If my people, listen, if family members, come on, we're going to keep it icy. We're going to keep it icy. If family members start speaking to you or want to shoot you over fucking $20 or a pair of sneakers or some fly-ass, funky-ass earrings, what makes you think they won't kill you over a fucking apple or a fucking bottle of water?
Yeah, in an apocalyptic time. Huh? Yeah, where everything is, like, tight.
Man, get the fuck out of here. Yeah. Wake up.
I'll kill you for a bottle of water. Yeah. That's
you know crazy. How many elderly people are going to die? How many elderly people? Because you're going to ask yourself right now. Your elderly aunt that's 40, I mean, that's up. Some of them are 40, but their bodies are deteriorating. They can't move. They can't run like that. So you're going to have to ask yourself a question. Do I stay back and I try to put auntie on my back and run up the street with my other kids? Do I do that? You see? Shit is reality hitting you. You understand? Because this is what this beast want. Total chaos.
This is the other being right here. You see his face. I'm going to zoom in super close so you can see, I mean, the clarity in his face. And this is fire, folks. Like, I tell people all the time, fire is living. I mean, this is crazy.
I know, y'all. Riz, it's all I got to go to. I got to go to work in the morning, people. In the morning. I got to get up early in the morning. But I told y'all, man, if it was anybody that I would want to be locked down with, man, the chat, I tell y'all, man, listen, besides Riz, you know what I mean, one or two other, you know, people, family members with me, man, that chat right there, I know we will be in this joint vibing. Motherfuckers be acting crazy outside. We be up in this joint. We be in here vibing. Oh, okay. You want to go with this one first?
Yeah.
No, man, don't cry.
That's from your video.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, over top of the moon that day?
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm. That looked like, I mean, yo, mm-hmm. I put this on my community post. It was so crazy. This is the moon right here. I'm going to zoom in on it. Y'all can just look at that for yourself. That's the moon from his video. Okay?
Y'all know damn well ain't no moon.
I don't know what the... I'm just got to show it, bro. That shit look like... Look at the stuff on top of
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
Like, what the hell is that? It's like a teapot. I mean, look at this. I mean, and then look. This was out off into the edge, like a crazy-looking demonic face with horns. Eyes, mm-hmm. mouth, I mean, clear to see.
And all these pictures are Riz pictures or off of my video, and I get Riz plenty of permission to use my pictures. So they won't block this video.
Yeah, bro,
I can't even pull that video up from 2018 that they blocked me for, people. They blocked me off YouTube from a video that me and Riz did live with pictures of 2018. I can't even pull a video up.
That's crazy. They got you blocked out, like you said.
October the 19th, people. October.
That's crazy. Yo, that's crazy. That's why Kalai going in, y'all. He like, you got to understand, he can't go live at all. And we got to give you that fire energy. Like you said, yes. It can't be done in a regular video.
No, I can't do it in a regular video and load it up to YouTube. It's I got different. To give you who I am.
Right.
I'm live. Saying live. I'm not, and this is what they, I know I can feel my energy changing, and this is what they don't want, you know what I mean? Because I speak with a vibrational tone, but my tone is loving, and people hear it, and even if they don't want to, they don't buy into what I'm saying, because I'm not asking you to buy into it, at least they I grab enough attention for you to listen. So if case something do pop up, the first thing will pop up in my mind is your voice, and then your inner voice will start talking to you. But I think Kalai was talking about this shit right here. That's just like I was in shop right the other morning grabbing water. And I was coming out of the line. This was 7:30 in the morning, my people. I was coming out of the line and the brother was walking past, and I had a mask on. And he was like, he was walking past me. I was like, he was like, are you Kali or Kalai? I'm like, yeah. He like, you be on Instagram? I'm like, yeah. He was like, man, I love you, brother, man. He embraced me, man, with so much love. Like, we knew each other. You know what I mean? He was like, I love you, man. And they don't want that. You understand? Because I don't give a fuck about the fact, even Brother Rap the News, Remedy H, or any other brother. I don't care what, if you believe in a religion or anything, the fact that we need to separate from these people and that we should love on one another is the main concern, because right now in the age of Aquarius, God, Satan is being revealed. So I don't have to really talk too much about that. Mm-hmm. Just the fact that us being together and talking to each other with love and nurturing and care. You see what I'm saying to you? And sometimes we have to understand and get up out of our fucking feelings and understand that sometimes love, nurturing, and caring is a strong vibrational tone voice. You see what I'm saying to you? Because go ask some people over in China. Huh? What kind of voice Mother Earth got? Huh? Huh? Is she singing like Patti LaBelle?
Wow. Keep it up, bro. I love it.
Yo. Is she singing like Patti LaBelle? Hitting that high toe? Huh? Huh?
Out of pocket.
Yo. Go over there and ask some people in Indonesia. Huh? Go ask Mr. MB33. What our big brother in the sky is saying. He got a glove on. Huh? He got to put two gloves on now. Mm-hmm. On the same hand. And all you got to do is hop in your skin.
Yeah, put some coconut oil on.
Come on, brother.
Shine,
baby.
Shiny as shit today. Hey, man. You know, trying to get my vitamin D levels up. Shout out China Miss Jones. This is from her video she did a couple days ago. Right after the storm, she caught the double rainbow. And when she was filming the video, she was like the rainbow was completely unobscured. And all of a sudden, these type situations start coming in. And she was like, yo, there's something up there looking like it's trying to block the rainbow out, or it's messing with the rainbow. And this creature right here, I mean, you can see it. I'm going to zoom in on his face. It's biting the rainbow. Literally biting the rainbow. You see his eye, gigantic face, and here's his mouth open. I'll zoom out, and you see the rainbow is right there. See his mouth? Now I'm going to zoom in on the face. Seeing is believing. You see him biting into the rainbow? Shout out China Miss Jones, because she did this live, and I saw it. I said, damn, I guess they're tired of the rainbow being out looking so beautiful. You know what I mean? Like, that's mother showing herself. You feel me? In all her vibrant, you know, colors.
Right.
And then these entities came and, like, covered it up, bro, to where so you couldn't even see it anymore. You know what I mean? But we know the energy was demonic, and it was intentional.
All those rainbows are 360 degrees, 369. Five things that ran through my head at one time with this nine thing. But anyway, all those rainbows are 360 degrees. They are all 90 degree angles, all of them. All the planets are on the right hemisphere of the sun, 180 degree angles, number nine. You have the president, who's number 45, president, the number nine. Barack Obama was number eight, number 40, whatever that is, 44. He was number 44 president. He was the number eight. He brought the lower half of the body to the upper half of the body. This is what the eight symbol stands for. He brought the lower half body up to the heart. This is where all the gay rights and all of that got passed through Barack Obama. The heart chakra. Have us now accept what? Homosexuality, transgender, transhumanism. This is what Barack Obama's job was to bring that in. And he brought it in.
He was in Newsweek with the rainbow over his head in the shape of a halo.
Yep.
That's symbolism within itself.
Exactly. Come on.
You know? And then, and the actual caption said, first gay president. I showed that to people, and they, oh, man, that ain't real. That ain't real. I said, bro, I gave you the actual cover, the publisher, the date it was published, and people still didn't want to believe it, bro. That's how much cognitive dissonance is real.
The white boy that came out and said he had had a sexual affair with Barack Obama and ended up being dead. The white woman that said that, I can't even think of her name. I did a video on this. If you go back, it's way back in my videos. I can't even think of her name. The white woman that mysteriously died that said everybody know Michelle Obama is a man.
What's her name?
I can't even think of her name. She died supposedly over plastic surgery. That's bullshit. She had many, many plastic surgery jobs. Joan Rivers. Exactly.
Joan Rivers.
Come on, man. All these people in front of you is just a, hey, listen, you have no idea, man. Trump is really like, he's frustrating the shit out of these pawns. Trump is playing with the pawns.
Yes.
He's frustrating the shit out of the pawns.
Yes, not checkers. playing a vicious game, man.
He gonna say, they go like, what about the attack in Lebanon? He said, yeah, it looked like a bomb. Look like an attack, like an explosion. He goes,
yo, I love the way you talk,
that's
bro.
That's what the general said.
He'd be like, yeah, China.
He said, but it all started with China. with the disease from China.
China.
Yo. I know y'all don't want to hear this either. Let me just say this to you. America is going to plumb, and then Russia and China is going to come in here only for the resources. Russia and China don't want nothing from America. But if you go look in that continent, their continent is being destroyed. They have no placement for their people. And I'm telling you this right now. Right now, people have nowhere to go in China. Millions of people. Millions upon millions of people. Cannibalism has already took place in South Korea and North Korea, all through the Asian community, and up in Russia. This has already taken place, my people, and in Indonesia. Cannibalism. They are already eating young children. Already. And it's going to happen here in America.
She already is. just people don't know.
They don't know it yet, but it's going to be outright in the open now.
Open, yeah.
It's going to be right outright in the open.
Yeah. There's videos online right now in certain, I think it's like Southeast Asian countries where it's groups of people going around at night and killing dogs and snatching them out of yards. They have big spears and stabbing dogs through the fence, then drag the dog out the fence and ride off on motorcycles. They're eating the animals.
Yo, I love the way I hear people be talking about, well, I'm here in the U.S. and I still got it's a lot of food here. I told y'all, America stockpiled for several months. This is why all other countries are focused on America right now. America stockpiled with food. Motherfuckers ain't gonna care about money. They care about food. How do you sell an army to go into America? Food. Ain't no resources. Ain't no more fucking oil. Ain't no more land. None of that. I want food.
Yeah. Control the population.
That's it.
You control their food. You control them.
And something is getting ready to happen in America. Something devastating gonna happen where though it's gonna be I tell you what. The crazy shit all gonna go down between now and the end of this year, before December the 14th. I'll tell you that much. But that major eclipse. If y'all can't see it right now, y'all know we already going in the house. And as soon as flu season pop, we going in the house. They need a couple more children to die, supposedly of COVID.
Right. just so they can spark it off again.
That's it. They just need a few more children to fake death.
Y'all see this giant face of this man looking down on her with the sad face? You see his eye. You see his fucking eyebrow, eye, hair, nose, mouth, gigantic white beard. Then I get into his hair. His hair is completely black, look like dreadlocks. You see it right here? I mean, I know that's clear to see, y'all. Shout out China Miss Jones for this picture, too.
Probably. Yo, it's sad when you can look down here. See? I understand that we don't understand, my people, and I love y'all. Just listen to me. I understand that we can't see that this was a test and we do believe that there is a God and a Satan. That's one thing. But it's another thing to denounce your culture and to follow someone that is using laws to murder you mentally and physically. That's all I got to say right there. Mm-hmm. Now, what God you know that will justify that? There, God didn't create any of these laws that we are following on this planet as a unit. Mm-hmm. As a unit. This is all I'm saying, as a unit, golden race. I'm not talking about the artificial race. You understand? I'm talking about as the golden race. God did not create these laws. Man created these laws in the name of God.
Yeah, all day long. That's why they call laws statutes. You know what I mean? Because in the Bible or in religious texts, you got laws, statutes, and commandments. And this is exactly what law enforcement, they're mimicking the same thing. Because everything's a code or a statute or a law. That's all it is. It's wordplay and symbolism.
Sit.
It's crazy. Give you and then use you.
All fucking day. All day.
I'm just going to show some quick UFOs that I captured, and then we probably wrap up because Colossi, they got to get up early tomorrow. So you could just take a look at them. It's just crazy.
Don't you guys still take it? Go on.
Yeah, I got just a couple drones and then boom. You know what I mean? Close up, you can see the cockpit and the dome.
Yes.
And I'm looking at green and purple all day long. I mean, you see the shape of the ship. This is extremely close in. I mean, it's beautiful. Y'all can just take a look at that. We're going to go to the next one.
That's just how you can tell, like, how the dimensions are coming together. And they move fast. Like, they just be flying through the fucking sky. Like, they just be moving.
Yeah, nothing can stop them. Okay, Chris, I got you, bro. Peace, love, and light to the chat. I see y'all. I love y'all. And I appreciate all y'all saying, like, y'all, you know, we doing too much over here because they cutting us out.
Right.
You know what I mean? Stopping the live and starting it back up.
Right.
That's just confirmation for you.
Exactly.
Take it with a grain of salt.
Right.
Doing something right. Another ship close up.
See, and I want to tell y'all something. When they talk about get ready for disclosure, my people, they're never going to disclose the truth. We have to accept that. The only way the truth is going to come out, my people, is when the sky completely open up, or at the point where, though, they can't, the artificial race can't come outside. this is where the truth starts to really unravel. But as far as them coming out and saying, oh, we are in contact with other life form, that is not full disclosure, my people. That's full disclosure for the artificial race to continue on their perpetuation, that they have some sort of anatomy license on this motherfucker on this planet. Genetic license. Let's just put it to you like that. Mm. And I have no hatred for none. I listen to, like I told you, and I wanna say this. I'm gonna say his channel, and I use him because I know that he does a lot of meditation, him and his wife, Evolution Energy Art. And I firmly believe within myself that he will not go out and kill, rape, murder a black child or a woman. I believe that. But that doesn't mean that he doesn't have the ability to spawn a child that will do so in the future. And that's the problem. See, that's what I'm trying to get my people to understand something. See, Sarah and Joseph that's standing in your face and laughing that you cool with on a basketball court, or you just hanging out at the bar, whatever the case may be. Yeah, that's cool. But you don't understand something. They have the potential to spawn something that is soulless. That's what you don't understand.
Shout out Matlock Soap. Crazy picture of a being's giant head, look like some type of beast, dragon, giant whale. I mean, you can see his eye and his other entities that's blent in to make up the entire image. I mean, you see the horn on top of the head, face, eye. I'll zoom in on the eye. And then if you look close, it becomes an entity that's right on the face of the beast. Black eye here, black eye there, something white on the forehead near the third eye. Then we got something crazy on top of his head that's a whole different color. Another face right under it. I mean, these beings are stacked on top of each other. I noticed that when I started sky watching that it could be 10 entities on one being. Like, that's crazy. Like, they're actually piled and stacked on top of each other. Face on top of face, body on top of body. Then right next to him, another one. I mean, the eyes give it up. I don't care what shape they are, you could see eyes. And then right here is like really ridiculous. Look at the shape of the eye. I'm looking at that on my phone. That don't even look real. That look crazy. Then we zoom out. It's a massive beast with a horn on his head, giant face. It's just crazy, folks. And this picture's from Canada.
Oh, it'd be popping up there.
Yeah, bro. Send me a lot of good pictures.
Time for growing on. There's so much. Time for growing on.
Another ship. Dragons and turtles, man. That's the common theme here, bro. I'm telling you. I believe what they call Earth, that I call hell, and what everybody know to be a living being is a gigantic fucking turtle. Real rat. And we living kind of like on its back. Yeah. From my research, that's what it's crazy. Yeah. And you can look at this, and this almost, I mean, it looked like a ship, but it also looked like it's organic too. I mean, look at that. It looked like some type of strange fish, but it's a massive UFO.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Another one, like DJ Khaled say. If you never saw a UFO, watch my channel or Kalai channel. We show them all the time. All the time. I'll zoom in closer so you can see. I mean, just look at the dimensions. You see that? I mean, look how dark that is in there. Like, and then the shape. cockpit. Let's see if I can get lucky. It's too pixelated. Normally, I'll take you in and show you a face of the person driving the vehicle. Hang out too much, become a real man.
Oh, it's the last one.
That's it?
Yeah, this one right here.
Mm-hmm. That's from that fire in Southern California,
woo,
the Apple fire. I posted it on my community post, and I watched the video live. It was 58 minutes long. Watched the entire video. And I saw all types of things and took a couple screenshots. And you could see the fire being. Mm. Look at that. I showed Kala a picture earlier where they showed these people being killed in a mortar accident. The two trainees and a photographer, and you could see entities pulling the soul out of the people before they were blown to pieces.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna do that on the next live.
Yeah.
On my life, it was an entity in front of the person, one soldier on the ground, and it was an entity behind one of the soldiers standing up. And if
they were like real close, yeah, too. They shoes is like
ready to pull him away.
Yo, that was crazy.
Yeah, and I'm trying to tell you, it was so bad. Everybody died because it was a training accident. Where you watch any old movie where you see a two man team dropping mortar rounds down a pipe, and then it takes off and shoots down range, and it normally takes two people, and the thing exploded and killed everybody, and you can see these beings snatching the souls out of the people before they're blown to bits.
Mm.
I showed that to Kala tonight. That's why I had to repeat it again.
That shit was crazy.
So understand, like that. I'm trying to tell you how this thing worked. It's way, way, way technical. It's crazy.
This shit's so technical. You put this shit together that you needed to take away all of your great abilities just to give these entities an opportunity to bring you to a place that, you know what I mean, that's not even you.
Peace, love, and light.
Yeah, that's
great show. I'm sorry, like, if the video chopped up, I'll rewatch it to see, but it was smooth sailing over here. No technical difficulties. I mean, everything's on our end is good, but we know what they're doing. It's all good, though.
Yeah, this shit is over, my people. You know, I don't know. I'm gonna do a video. I don't know. I know it ain't gonna get out like I wanted to, but I'm gonna do a video on the things that I have prepped as far as getting. I'm gonna tell you right now off the bat. Get yourself a survival kit. Get yourself a bag, like a traveling, like a book bag, a tactical. Traveling outdoor bag. Get yourself one of them. Get yourself a solar panel. I'm getting a solar generator so I can charge up my devices in case the power go out, which I believe the power is going to go out, but the sun is not going to go out, so you'll still be able to charge up your devices. What else? I got a night vision, binoculars. I got a flashlight. I don't got that cheap flashlight. Go online, get yourself a high power. I'm gonna have the pictures and the links and stuff when I do the video. A high power light, a flashlight. Listen, this is your life, my people. You're not afraid to die, but you're not just gonna hand your fucking life over. You don't see no lion when another lion come up. When a lion got his pride, right? He spent his whole day protecting his pride because he know that's his life. That's his lifeline. That when another lion walk up, the other lion ain't just gonna hand his motherfucking pride over to him and be like, all right, boy, you got it, no, man. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? No. So you ain't gonna hand yourself over to no one. You understand? Those days is over. So I'm just saying to prep yourself and be self-sufficient. This is the thing, being self-sufficient, not being able to depend on them for at least 6 months, and also being able to move. You understand? Being able, like, you know what? I got the shit on me. I got the right gear on, and I got the shit in my bag that if I need to sleep outside, I can go outside. A tent, $19, $20. You ain't gonna light no fire at fucking night. You drawing on yourself. You feel what I'm saying to you? So you gonna dress warm and put yourself in a tent? Shit, you might not even set. Me, I wouldn't even sleep in that motherfucker. So I'll put this, I'll set the tent up and sleep in the grass all the way across from the tent. Mm. So a motherfucker walk up to the tent. You see where I'm thinking at? This is all I'm saying, people. This is just a mind to get you from this dark, small period. It's gonna feel like it's gonna be a long time, but it's gonna be a short period. Just a small dark period into the light, into the age of Aquarius. That's all it is. So just a small little thing, necessities that you would need. Get that stuff. In the meantime, water, dry food, nothing that you're gonna have to put in an oven or cook on the stove. Stuff that you can,
canned goods,
cans that you can, shit that you can, or you can open up a fucking can on some rocks. I learned that today. Survival. Look, being Riz talking to me, and we pull the joint up. How you open up a can just in case without a can open? Have a can, scratch that shit on some rock, open it up. Mm-hmm. You can eat that. Listen, when you in survival mode, right? You know why we eat all day? Because motherfuckers got content with slow death. We're relaxed. So we think we living. We're only existing. So now when you in survival mode, really, just to get through the age of Aquarius, you're not eating as much. You're thinking. That's what you're doing. A worried person is talking all motherfucking day long. A scared motherfucking person is crying and talking all fucking day long. You quiet and thinking. You might even be like, yo, I got to get the fuck away from them so I can think for a little bit. You understand? And that's just real rap, my people. So
in a survival situation, you don't need to cook. You can live out of a bag or a can. With dried fruits, you know, if you eat meat, it could be a jerky, you know what I mean? Or just canned foods or dehydrated foods you just add water to, stir and eat. Canned food is a go. You don't need to cook nothing when you're trying to survive. I guarantee you, you'll be so stressed you won't even be thinking about food
at all. You won't even be thinking about that shit. You'll be on some, you know what I mean? Even those that feel as though that they already prepared and everything, your mind is, your whole mind frame is gonna change.
Yeah.
Because you're gonna hear what's going on outside. You understand? You're gonna wanna go outside naturally in the sunlight. So and then when you go outside, you're gonna have to be on point and watch yourself. You gotta be careful about the food that when you're eating this shit. And you can't put empty cans out in front of your door. Mm. You know what I mean? You can't even be going to go take shits outside like that because guess what? Well, I'll be like, yo, why he going to the bathroom every fucking day? This dude going to the bathroom. And he be over there for like 2 hours. What the fuck he got in this house? I ain't got no food. My daughter crying. Yeah. She ain't got no. Come on, man. See? Real shit. Motherfuckers like 100. Yeah, because I'm talking real shit. You got to be in survival. It's not that you hate your people. It's not none of that. You have to start thinking as far as for survival. That's just all it is. To get through this time, that's all it is, my people.
Yeah.
That's it. You have to watch each other's back. You feel what I'm saying? Like it's nothing. You have to watch each other's back. And really care and speak to each other. You can't just be in there, everybody will fucking go. Nah, man, we're going to be relaxed. Yo, what's up, man? Like, how you feel? Like, really, that's when we start communicating and really talk to each other. If we focus on the shit that's going on outside and not talking within your circle, then we'll never heal one another because it's really a healing moment. So we can't focus on the devastation and shit that's going outside. The people that build their bond together, they got to start talking and communicating. Like, yo, listen. We know what's going on out there. Like, what's going on internally with you? Did you dream last night? What was your vision? See, me, I will wake up in the morning, fucking fuck me eating an apple. I'll cut the apple in half and get a star seed, an apple and some water, and be like, yo, did you dream last night? How did you feel? Like, what did you see in your dreams?
Right.
You know what I mean? Did you see anything? Like, let me know the next time you dream. Let me know. See what I'm saying?
Damn,
you
see? Serious.
And I'm talking. That's how the fuck I would be talking to the young star seeds.
They see? Got it.
I'd be giving them fruits and water. Like, huh? Take this.
Feeding their brain.
And talking to them. Like, yo, listen. What did you feel last night? I know you know the stuff that's going on outside.
Right.
What you think? How you feel? You know what I mean? And mind you, so kids gonna be nervous. They're gonna be young, so they nervous. You understand? So it's up to you to empower that nerve, to empower them so they don't be nervous.
Right.
You understand? Turn to them like you the future. Yep. I have to go to you because the universe is speaking directly to you right now. What you mean? Like, listen, the universe is talking to you. Just be sensitive to that inner voice. Don't worry. Just speak freely. Tell me how you feel. What's going on outside? You know what I mean? Like, we're going to go outside. We're going to walk to the corner. Do you think we need to walk? You think that we need to start moving? Do the weather feel different to you? You understand what I'm saying? Because if shit, a kid may be able to sense that it might start getting cold. fuck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Anything.
Adults, we so tensed up, we lost our connection to every motherfucker.
Message. Day.
You see what I'm saying to you? That's where I'm at with it, my people. That's where I'm at with it. Yeah. So, I mean, like, maybe I'm off the, maybe I'm way off my square. But
you know,
that's
you know most people with kids, oh, man, I want to hear that. Get ready. But if you nurture that, you'll get a
you get a total different response.
Yo, you getting something that's
right.
Just I can't even explain it, bro. It's not connected to this world, and it just came from a place where it still got a divinity.
Exactly.
It's not corrupt.
Yeah, especially if you still you empowering the kid. You're telling the kid, like, this is all happening because of you, because of us. We're the golden race. The sun is unlocking your DNA. Oh, really? This and the third. You start empowering them and start talking to them. I don't care what kid it is. I'm going to be talking. If I don't have no kids, they have outside. I start listening. This is what's happening. And I start empowering them. And then the kid, the moment that kid dream, wake the fuck up and look directly for you. Out of everybody, look directly for you. Yep. Yo, this is what I dreamed about last night.
Yep.
Do you think this is happening? I don't care if he told me he saw Superman fly through the fucking sun and came out on the other side. That was a spaceship or one of our brothers and sisters. You see? That's the shit I'm on. Oh, really? Oh, okay. Shit is popping up there then. Wow. See? That's the difference with me, my people. I love y'all. You know what I mean? A Rizzo's show, anything you want to say.
Man. Peace, love, and light. Love y'all. Thank y'all for coming. Minus the gremlins, you know, doing what they do. It's all love. You know what I mean? Give it to them, bro.
Yes, and I'm going to end it with this. Just to reassure to know y'all why children are so pure, go look at the movie. Go look at Dracula movies. Go look at children going to go missing in this world. And now go look at COVID-19. Who holds more bacteria between the ages of 0 and 5? Who holds more bacteria in their nose now between the ages 0 and 5? Children, huh? Now children between the ages of 0 and 5 hold more bacteria of the COVID-19 in their nose. But therefore, they may not show any symptoms, but they're probable to pass it off. So they need to be vaccinated so they don't pass it the fuck off. See? Yo, man, this these beasts is crazy, but they won't get no child that's around us. Let me just say that. No child.
Mind games. That's what they doing.
No fucking child. Yeah. Let me tell you that. They won't get no child that's around us. I believe that.
Watch the movie Dr. Sleep. They're telling you how they feeding off of young children.
Seriously, they won't get no fucking young child about any. Matter of fact, on this block right here, any young child on this fucking block, you lost your fuck. Ain't nobody. Nah. None of that. Ain't none of that. And hopefully, when they see the way I give up my vessel and I take at least 4 or 5 of them out to fuck with me, then that'll wake the rest of them the fuck up. If he ain't give up his, if he was willing to give up his fucking vessel for us, for our children, why the fuck we ain't willing to give up our own vessel for our own children? And that's real shit. That's where I'm at with it. So I love y'all, my people. Love, light, and supreme cosmic energy. Before I do that, I want to thank Riz again for letting me be on your platform
all day, bro. It's my pleasure.
You know,
I've
been blocked off of YouTube. I don't want to load up videos, my people, because I don't think all of y'all are going to see them. So this is why I don't be. I do it on Instagram, yes, but I every now and then I load a video up on YouTube. But thank you again for letting me use your platform. Everybody that's in the chat, I love y'all sincerely. Love, light, and supreme cosmic energy to all the queen goddesses, to all the beautiful, lovely star seeds, to all my fellow king gods who see the multiverse and the Fibonacci in us. We see the multiverse and the Fibonacci in you. I see you. I honor you. I appreciate you. And we fucking love you, my people. Excuse me. We love you, my people. Because somebody correct said something like, Cloud, I don't like when you say fucking love you because I don't want to affiliate no fucking with it. All right. You right. And guess what? Look at how I checked myself. Because you know why? It didn't make it. Well, a multidimensional being said that to me. If they said it with love. So I said, you know what? You right. So I love you, my people. I don't fucking love you. I sincerely, cosmically love you. I sincerely. And don't let no one dim that light in you. You are beautiful. We are unique. We are amazing people. They built this whole system. We built the whole planet, but they built this whole system to trap each and every last one of us. And look at where we are today. Look at where we are today. We are rising as one. I love you, my people. As we rest, maybe do the electric slide, meet up in the cosmos, do the electric slide, and speed up the process to remove all darkness on this planet and to shed nothing but light. I love you, my people, sincerely.
Peace, y'all.